and welcome to CM9798 Plays. My name is Dave, and this week we are playing FIFA 98 on the SNES. Now I know what you're thinking. You think of FIFA 98, you think of FIFA Road to World Cup 98, one of the best games to really be released on the PlayStation. You're thinking indoor mode, you're thinking Blur Song 2 with intro, you're thinking it's going to be good. Now that's what I was thinking when I bought this game, because when this was released, which is back in 1997 of course, I didn't have a PlayStation, and I played FIFA 98 at my friend's house and thought this is an incredible game. Went to the shop, saw FIFA 98 on the shelf for the SNES, the little SNES which I had. Let's buy it. And well, let's just say it's not the same as we saw on the PlayStation. So as it's a FIFA game, I suppose the plus is you've got some licensed teams, and you've got lots of teams as well. So, as you can see, I can be Albania, I can be Belarus, I can be England. I've messed that up. I was going to change, we're playing against someone other than Germany, but let's not. I'll just play against Germany, right, we'll figure it out afterwards. So far so good, you know, got a nice menu here, it's team coverage, which I'm guessing means squads. Oh no. So whatever that hell, whatever that means, that's what we're doing. Attack, always attack. And yes, we'll play a sweeper system, I guess. I don't know, come on. Okay, so we've got players, and real players at that, and they've got a skill rating, and Tony Adams, Stuart Pearce, Sol Campbell, Gazza, McManaman, Anderton, David Baddy, Beckham, Ferdinand, and Shearer. And the subs, Flowers, Ince, Sheringham, Ainwright. Not the biggest squad in the world, but that's fine, you know, we can live with that. So we go to starting lineup. I'm going to assume it's going to take us back to where we were anyway. Is that an A at the bottom for swap? What's it meant to be? It looks like a 2. Ah, man, my eyes are getting worse. Oh no, it isn't here. And I could bring Ainwright in for Les Ferdinand, and I might do that. And if you scroll right, you can see that's going to be speed and read ball control. Maybe, surely they should have thought about this menu. Like, it cuts off a lot of important lettering there. Agility. Having the bicycle kick ability is good to know. These are all features which I'm sure will feature heavily in the game. Start, right. We'll look at the options before we go, in case I can, you know, knock down the skill level. Match type, action. Don't know what that means. Simulation, action. That's good. Half length, 4 minutes. Bring it down to 2 minutes. Goalkeeper's computer, fouls, off. Normal. Injuries off, offsides, on. Passing arrows on, power circle on, player numbers, clock, continuous, time display on, auto replay, pitch texture, music and sound effects. Right, so far, lots of stuff to get excited about in there. Let's play football. So you can see from what we've looked at so far, there's some things in there to get excited about, but then you come to the gameplay, and what we have is this, which, I mean, somewhere I have a man, there he is. And you've got a circle that moves faster than the speed of sound to try and control your players. That's a throwout to no one in particular. There's an auto tackle. It's just madness. It's an absolute carnage. I think I've got the ball. I've lost the ball. I've hit the keeper. I'll boot it over there and hope for better times. I know what you're thinking. Dave, you've played a lot of SNES games recently, you've been terrible at all of them. And you're right, I have been, but this one... well, what can you say about this one? It's just... even the angle of the pitch is annoying. Like, why are we playing this as though we're in the crowd? Like, do we need to see that much of the crowd during the game? Probably not. I'm not even 100% sure I'm dribbling the ball here. I've got no idea at all what's going on. That's not me. So, that's a good throw to play though. And it's half time, I think. No, it's not, it's just a needlessly elaborate cutscene. So there's no commentary, you haven't got lovely Dares interviews and things, you haven't got John Motson on commentary, which might not be the worst thing in the world. There's zero presentation. I've got absolutely no idea what I'm doing. A seems to hoof the ball in some direction. And just to set yourself back in time to when I'd have bought this, and I'll have been about 10, spent my pocket money on this, and rushed home, expecting to play FIFA 98, and playing this instead, and wondering where it all went wrong. Luckily, I got a PlayStation a few months later, and got FIFA 97, which was okay. It wasn't FIFA 98, was it? We do love indoor mode though. I would love to, probably will relive that at some point. Now you're going to mention it. Right, what's my options here? So I've got a throw in. I can't move in any direction. I can press A, which throws the ball over there for some reason. Have they scored? They have. But to no fanfare, you just get a replay. I mean, that's an absolute wallop. It's knocked David Seaman over. Just not very good. See, like, I have the ball here, and I'm not joking, like, when I make a movement, it's probably taking a couple of seconds to actually make the movement. I hate FIFA. Maybe this is why I hate FIFA. Maybe this game is what caused it. Right, I'm not playing this anymore, okay. Garbage. Absolute garbage. And even pausing the game slow. Yes, let's quit, please. Good, right, we're back here. So far, not good. Maybe some of the features will save it. So it's got leagues, it's got penalty kick shootout, it's got practice. It's got Road to World Cup 98, which was of course the main feature. And you can choose which continent you want to qualify from, so we'll go UEFA. And as you see, you work your way through the teams, they've all got different skill sets. Again, nothing unusual about that. There's England, Faroe Islands of course, Georgia, Germany. Germany's just got full whack for everything except tackling, bizarrely. I mean, some of these countries you can't really read because they've put like white writing on the white bit of the flag. And is the Liechtenstein flag white, red and blue and black? I don't think it is. Likewise, Macedonia is not black and orange. I couldn't tell you that is. Moldova, maybe? Northern Ireland. The famous white and red of Northern Ireland. Republic of Ireland, right? Let's be them just for... Just cause. Now this is the main feature of this game, so I'm expecting big things. That's a mighty group. Is that all one group? That's crazy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9 teams in the group? Seems like a lot, doesn't it? Anyway, notice I wasn't one of the teams in the group. I am over playing Romania, so that'll be good. No. Because it's like an important match. Maybe there'll be some fanfare this time. No, no fanfare at all. We're just here, at the pitch side, ready to play. And that, I don't know what you call it, it's not a horn, it's like a... It's the one thing you get as crowd noise. But, why is it so difficult to do everything? See, like... I'm not making these tackles. Someone's making the tackles, but not me. And so delayed. And it's just... That's just a worry. Yes, throw it to him, please. Oh. I don't know how to shoot. I assumed B. It wasn't B. Yeah. There. You fancy. Didn't come to anything. The clock is also... One of my pet peeves in football games is when they don't just have, like, a 90-minute clock, but going down at, like, a quick pace. Like... Unless I've actually set this to play a full 90 minutes, which would be a mistake, to say the least. But I assume it's going to get to, like, 2 minutes, and then tell me it's half-time or something. At least let's hope that's what it's going to do. None of these buttons do anything. Why is like a... I don't know. I just don't know why I was meant to be. Some sort of pass or something, I don't really know. There's a lot of automatic sliding going on. He's throwing it to absolutely nobody. It's just abysmal, right? We've been through some things on this channel, we've seen some things. And this is comfortably the worst of all the games I've played. Like, has that gone in? I heard John Watson there. It's a good, well, it's a goal, alright. Look at the crowd. Barely cheering. Is this counted or what? It has counted. I've got nothing good to say about it. It's half time, so I was right. It does just count up. I'm not going to play on because I'm annoyed. I don't like this game. Literally, if you play any other game in the world, you'll have a better time than playing FIFA 98. I think it is the worst football game that I ever played. And I count my experiences on the Commodore, the Amstrad, obviously the SNES, the PlayStation. Probably some PC games. It is just awful. Even the appearance of Footix in the top left does nothing for me. And I love Footix. He's probably the best of the mascots, but even he can't save this. I hate it. I hate your FIFA. FIFA 99 was alright on the PlayStation 1, I'll give you that, right? I enjoyed FIFA 99, we can have that. Everything else is terrible. And I don't count the official World Cup games, because they're not FIFA games. They're official World Cup games. They're okay. But this is not. I hope this never ever darkens your doors. 1 out of 10. At best. I've got nothing good to say about it. Not one thing. Not one thing saves it. It's just awful. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you'd like to subscribe and get more of this, please do subscribe. Find me on Twitter at CM9798, and I'll be back again with more absolute nonsense. Bye for now.